From the Scripps Studios, this is 10 News.
Hello, I'm Jim Patton with this 10 News update. A fire left smoldering in Otay Mesa more than 12 hours after it started. Happened at Tito's Metal yesterday afternoon. Owner says one of their machines caught fire and it quickly got out of control. All eight employees were able to make it out. Close to 100 firefighters responding to this fire. They got that fire out, but some firefighters worked through the night to make sure that the flames didn't start back up. Investigators looking into the cause. Four of the people who were on the plane that landed at MCAS Miramar for quarantine yesterday are now in local hospitals after showing signs of illness. Two adults were taken to UC San Diego, and one adult and a child were taken to Rady Children's Hospital. All four had a fever or a cough when they arrived in San Diego, so they were sent to the hospitals to be checked out. Right now, it's not clear if any of them have the coronavirus. Could take several days for the CDC to test results. San Diego's bicycling community joining some local leaders today for a three-day bike summit. It's being put on by the San Diego Bike Coalition. The summit aims to bring new ideas to improve bicycling in the region and to talk about successful projects. There will also be a mayoral candidate forum tomorrow. Summit ends on Saturday. And today, San Diego State students can start using the school's new game day ticket process. Last week, the site crashed when students logged onto the mobile site to claim their free ticket for the men's basketball game. Well, now the school has implemented a new claim process on SDSUStudentTix.com. They can only purchase home game tickets. Students can start purchasing tickets today when the Aztecs play New Mexico next Tuesday. The team's record 23-0. Time now to get a check on our weather. How are we doing, Megan?
Well, we're warming up for the rest of the week. Not only the days, but also the nights. Temperatures this afternoon, low to mid-60s at the coast, mid to upper 60s and near 70 for our inland neighborhoods. 50s in the mountains with 70s in the deserts. Temperatures remain in the mid-60s along our coastline through Saturday, and then cooler Sunday and Monday with highs in the upper 50s and low 60s as our next chance for rain arrives. That will be late Sunday into Monday. Inland neighborhoods were in the 70s tomorrow and Saturday, 60s and 50s for highs for inland neighborhoods as well, Sunday and Monday. Jim?
Megan, thank you. And for the latest news, weather, and traffic, go to 10news.com or download our free 10 News app in your app store. For 10 News, I'm Jim Patton.